there and welcome to another Photoshop tutorial from Iceflow Studios. And in this tutorial, I'm going to be touching on the basics of animation in Photoshop. Now, if you're using Photoshop CS2 or below, this video will be a little bit irrelevant because Photoshop CS2 and below uses a standalone program which comes with Photoshop called Image Ready. In Photoshop CS3, animation is actually built right into Photoshop. And I'm going to be touching on that right now. In this video, we're going to be covering the basics, and then later on, I'm going to be covering advanced materials of animation in Photoshop. Now, in front of us, we have a very quick example that I made yesterday of an animation within Photoshop. Here at the bottom is our animation timeline. We can view our animation by frames, or we can view the actual timeline right here. Now, like in most animation and video programs, you have to render your animation before it actually looks any decent. So if I go back to my frame by frame view and I click on play, you'll notice the animation is moving very, very slowly. That is because it's not rendered. If we head back into our timeline view and we go back to the beginning and we start to play it, you'll notice that there's a bar right here. This blue bar is being filled. The blue area is the area that has been rendered. So if I let this go for a few seconds, you'll notice it's very choppy. That's because it's rendering. Let me stop it and go back, and we're going to start playing it over the blue area, and it's nice and smooth until it gets to an unrendered area. So how do we go about creating an animation in Photoshop? Let's minimize this and we'll bring up a new document. So here we go. We're going to make a blank white document. And we're going to do something very, very simple. We're going to grab an ellipse tool. We're going to make a very simple ellipse. Now, how do we actually start animating this? Well, the first thing you need to make sure you have is your animation window at the bottom. And if you don't see this, you probably won't. If you go to Window and then click on the Animation button, that'll bring up this animation palette at the bottom. What we need to make sure of is that our animation palette is in frame by frame mode in order to start animating. If by chance it looks like this, which is the timeline mode, at the bottom right hand corner there's a button. If we hover over it, it says convert to frame animation. If we click on that, we'll be taken to our frame by frame view. Now you'll notice a few things. We have a few buttons. This button right here, which if we hover over it, it says duplicate selected frames. That will actually duplicate our current frame in order for us to be able to animate the next frame. We have our playback buttons right here, which because we don't have any other frames, we can't play it back. We have this right here, which allows us to loop our animation just once or over and over and over again. You'll also notice this right here. It says 10 seconds. Well, what does that mean? Well, basically, this frame right here will be held for 10 seconds. So if we duplicate this frame, every frame will be held for 10 seconds before it goes to the next frame. Well, we don't want that for a nice smooth animation. So if we click on the down arrow, we have the option to choose how long each frame is held for, and we can customize it for each individual frame. So for a nice flowing animation, I'm going to set it to no delay. So let's begin animating. The first thing we need to do, we need to position our ball in its starting point. So I'm going to make this ball go kind of like a bouncing motion. So I'm going to start it in the bottom left hand corner, and once it's in the starting point, we're going to duplicate this frame by clicking on the duplicate frame button. Just like that. And you'll notice it's added a second frame. What we're going to do now, we're going to position it in its next location. So I want the ball to kind of go up like this, and then we're going to start going back down in a minute. So once you have it in its second location, we actually have to tween the frames, which kind of means put it together in a nice smooth transition. So once you have your second frame selected, we're going to click on this button, which is our tween animation frames. We're going to click on that, and we have our new dialog box. Now we can select, we can choose to tween with the previous frame or the very first frame. Now if you're trying to make a nice smooth selection with the starting point and its next transition, you want to select previous frame. We also have the option to select how many frames to add in between. Now, if you want a very quick transition, add very few frames. If you want a nice long transition, add more frames. I'm going to put it around 5, and I'm going to choose all layers, and all these are fine. Now, let me add one more thing. Animation in Photoshop isn't that advanced. You can only animate a few things. You can't animate rotation. You can't animate transformation. You can animate things like position, opacity, and effects. That's about it. It's not that advanced. So we're going to click OK, and you'll notice at the bottom, it's added the frames in between. So if we click through this, you'll notice that it's added that transition. And if we head back to our timeline and we play it back, there you go. So back to our frame by frame mode. We're going to select our last made frame. We're going to duplicate it and we're going to position it in its next position. So I'm going to move it down like this. Once that's done, we're going to tween it one more time. The settings should all be the same. Click OK. Duplicate. Next location. Tween. OK. Duplicate. Next location. Tween. OK. There's a lot of repetitive movements when you're doing animation within Photoshop. So one more time. Duplicate. Position. Tween. OK. And last time. Duplicate. Position. Tween. And OK. So if we go back to our timeline and we play it back, it's going to go through and render it once. And then it's going to start playing back nice and smooth. So that's a very quick animation in Photoshop, very, very simple. Like I mentioned, you can't animate a lot of advanced features. You can't rotate and add it to an animation. You can't transform, play with nodes, things like that. You can do opacity, which is kind of nice. So let me go back here. So let's say at the end we wanted the opacity to go down a little bit. We've duplicated it already. We're gonna move it to the bottom here. And let's go over here to our layers palette, decrease the opacity, go to tween, click OK, and you'll notice that it actually transitions to the last opacity number, just like that. So one more time. Going to go through and render it, and there you have it. Very basic animation in Photoshop, and you can animate many, many layers at a time. And once you're finished, if you want to export it, go to File, Export, Render Video, and you're given a bunch of options here. You can name it, you can select where to save it, you can select what kind of file format. There's a lot of nice customization options that they include in exporting your video. So this was a very basic video on animating within Photoshop. If you are using ImageReady, which comes with CS2 and below, a lot of it is the same, but it's not built directly into Photoshop. In future tutorials, I will be going into more advanced features of animation in Photoshop, but like I mentioned, there's not a lot of advanced features within the animation aspect of Photoshop. So, I hope you learned something from this tutorial. If you're looking for more tutorials, check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/iceflowstudios or tutcast.com. And until next time, this is Howard from Iceflow Studios. Take care.